The state of Florida solves the looting and rioting problem. Just shoot them.
Mr. Reagan.
So, Governor Ron DeSantis has proposed a bill protecting Floridians who shoot rioters and looters. Now, okay, even many conservatives are going to look at this and go, whoa, you're essentially legalizing murder here. But that's not quite right. The bill does actually make blocking traffic a felony, which I think is also very important, but it also grants immunity to drivers who run over protesters, which I think is going pretty far. Is it crossing a line? See, this is the kind of stuff that I love, a bill like this, because this is something where you have to get into the philosophy of, you know, political philosophy at its core, like, you know, really the ethics of how you govern and what laws are ethical and what laws are unethical. Now, I would say this. Is it ethical to shoot somebody who's looting your store? I actually think that it is. Because you cannot live in a society in which it is legal to go in and destroy somebody's property, to loot their store, to destroy their livelihood. To me, this kind of thing should be illegal. Okay, and every governor and mayor who ruin the livelihoods of hundreds, if not thousands of Americans by destroying their business through lockdowns because of COVID, I think they all should answer for that as well. But if you're going into a store, physically going into a store, you know, I mean, at least the governors and mayors, they can say, well, that wasn't our intention. That was just a sort of, you know, incidental side effect. If you're going into a store to, like, rob the store and destroy things and ruin somebody's life and livelihood, then there's no excuse for that. There's no justification for it. There needs to be consequences for that, and there haven't been. And so that encourages people to do it some more, right? And so we're getting into a situation where these riots, they're escalating, right? Before 2020, you would occasionally have a riot here, you know, looting there, something like that. But throughout 2020, you had these protests that would turn violent or turn a little bit volatile. And then as these riots built up, they became more and more violent. They became more and more volatile. You'd get more stores broken into. You'd get more stuff looted. You'd get more people hurt. And eventually people started to get killed, right? If you're in a situation in which your store is being destroyed and your family is going to, you know, no longer have a business and you're no longer going to have a good way of making any money, yeah, I think you need to be able to protect that. And I'm not saying you should shoot anyone, but I do think you should be given the authority to do so. Because being given the authority to do so, that act alone will stop people from looting a store. If somebody believes that if they loot that store and there's somebody in there with a gun, they can legally shoot me, they will think twice about looting the store. And you sort of end looting that way. And you end these kind of riots and the destruction of personal property that way. Again, do I think you should shoot somebody who's looting your store? I mean, that's tough. It's a situational kind of thing. But I think you should have the right to do it. And the same with the traffic thing, right? Blocking traffic, you can kill people that way, right? If they block a highway and there's this massive traffic jam and there's somebody, you know, in an ambulance there that's going to die if they don't get to the hospital and they die in that ambulance, you got blood on your hands, right? So that stuff, that kind of thing needs to be made illegal. And I think that this is a great idea for that. Now, I don't know if it's necessary right now. I mean, I don't, maybe this is a bill that could potentially be good for future problems. So maybe it should be signed. But I'm not sure if it's necessary at the moment. The reason I don't think it's necessary at the moment is simply because where are all the rioting? You know, where's all the rioting? What happened to all the BLM protests? What happened to all the looting? Why did it... You notice that it suddenly stopped, right? We're almost over November, right? November's almost gone. We had the election at the very beginning of the month. There was a few protests. There was a little bit of craziness right after the election, but then it just died down. Then it just died off. There was nothing. There's nothing. What happened to the Black Lives Matter protest? Do Black Lives no longer matter, people? I mean, what's happening here? Do you no longer want your Rolex watches? Why aren't you looting anymore? Why aren't you rioting? What happened to the protest? It's almost like you guys never cared about Black Lives to begin with. It's almost like you never cared about the police. It's almost like you never cared about any of that stuff. It's almost like these were all orchestrated to try to get Trump out of office. That's what it seems almost like, but Far be it from me to speculate on such things. All right, well, that is it for me, and I will see you guys next time.
There are going to be millions of Democrats that are going to vote with us this time around because they, too, want that promise kept. It was a promise for less government and less taxes and more freedom for the people.
If it was not for the elders correcting the mistakes of the young, there would be no state.